She's top gonna take it, whether you're applauding or hating. I give us more motivation, we gonna make it. The seat top's gonna take it, whether you're applauding or hating. I give us more motivation, we gonna make it. The seat top's gonna take it, whether you're applauding or hating. I give us more motivation, we gonna make it. The seat top's gonna take it, whether you're applauding or hating. I give us more motivation.
Another talented artist, man. You right now watching it. I'm Dirty Promesa. Right here on my left is Pnova, reigning from Harlem, residing in New Jersey. Been all over, even the Bronx. You know what I'm saying? We all over the place. We right now filming it at Ornament Studios. Thanks to Dutch Shelter providing the location, the entertainment. We got a couple of people. We got Ramel FaZe in up on the side looking in. We also got my man Dane that I know him as. You know what I'm saying? Sorry if I said your name or not, but I respect it. You know what I'm saying? I love you. You know what I'm saying? So, you know me, got his brother in the background. You know what I'm saying? Vine Entertainment's up in the house, man. This is Sought Out TV series, man. Pnova right now. Once again, I'm Dirty Promesa. Anybody interested in doing the show, man, hit up the email, TakeOver Promotions, number4@gmail.com. But right now, our feature, sitting down right here, he just spit some hot shit before we even got live on this camera, on the air right now. Some hot shit, man, that you know you can follow through on the SoundCloud. It's Pnova right here, man. So, Pnova, tell my fans. I know you, but tell the fans who you are, man.
Oh, man. Some of the fans sure already know me, man. You know, I've been on the grind for a minute since I've been home. I mean, Pnova, man. PNovacane, man. Pnova is for the short, man.
And that's your SoundCloud page? That's how you got it?
Yeah, Pnovacane, Pnovacane, you know what I mean? On YouTube, Pnovacane. Everything's P. It's P, man. It's with the P, man. Pnova, you know what I'm saying? Everything's with the P, man.
I've been knowing, you know, P for about 2 weeks now, 2-3 weeks, man. I invited him to do the show, do some other things creative. Like I always do, I network with other artists, talented features that's up and coming that like to support. That basically the hashtag would always promote grind for their dreams, you know what I'm saying? That's what we're doing right now for the Sought Out TV series, you know? So tell me a little more, man. What made you come up with the name Pnova? You know everybody always have to know why. What's the name about, man? How you found that name, man?
I'm from Harlem, so I grew up in Harlem, you know what I'm saying? Straight out of Mount Sinai Hospital and all that. But P, they was calling me Peanut in my hood, so The P always stood with me, you know what I mean? As far as, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, I ain't gonna call myself Peanut. I'm gonna get, you know what I mean? My name, you know, Pnovacane is, you know, I used to be in the street, and that's, I used to leave the fiends numb, because I used to give them that good, you know what I mean? That good. I used to leave them numb. So that's why Pnovacane, it was just right. Like, Peanut, I could keep my P. Novacane, like, because I was in the streets hard, and I was just giving them, like, they came back. I kept them coming back. Just put it like that, man.
We're getting a little more into that right now. But your SoundCloud, you got a song called Code 187. That's you with Fly Mugga.
And me, Fly Mugga, Scorch, Foster, what's up?
Turn Up, Novacane, Fly Scorch. Turn Up, Scorch, over 1,000 views on that joint, man. That's good numbers, man. Always
been out for a little while now. Yeah, the numbers, you know, been out for a little while now. Speaking of Scorch, he just stepped in the building.
Oh, okay, man. So that's the man. You know, we live. We shooting this right now, you know what I'm saying? I ain't even going to edit none of this, man. We're going to let people know that people coming in the building.
The homie just stepped in, you know what I'm saying? It's lit right now.
You know, so how's your relationship since you met Fly Mugga? How's your relationship with you? Got a couple of songs with
them
together.
Yeah, everything, me, Fly Mugga, man, you know, I've been knowing Fly Mugga for about 6 years now, man. 5.5, 6 years.
And you met him in open mic, right?
Yeah, I met him in the open
mic. That's how it is, networking.
Yeah, that's it. It was just networking, man. On 2nd Avenue, I met him in there and all that, yo. He was 17 years old. First track we did was The Life, you know, killed it, man. We did our thing, you know what I'm saying? The song got bars, like, I was feeling it from the first track. So, you know, I put him on board. Basically, I still told him, yo, do your thing, because he was repping his YFMG, PDG thing. Yo, I told him, keep doing your thing, man. Like, rep that, you know what I'm saying? I'm Vine ENT. But I just want to show you how this thing go. Like, we can get it together. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because I feel like I'm nice. I feel like you nice. We can get it together. So he you know, he rolled with it. He stood on, you know what I'm saying? And he's still rocking with us, you know what I'm saying? It's a friendship.
Music, you know?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, but you know, he doing his thing right now. He got a lot of shit on his plate too. He got a lot of shit coming, you know what I'm saying? Like you said, you heard that Cut It freestyle. So that's gonna be on
that's on the SoundCloud, right?
Yeah, that's on the SoundCloud, but that's also gonna be on the Trilogy part too.
So with Violent Entertainment, how many of y'all is it a group thing or, you know, a clique thing or just like everybody does?
Vine Entertainment is the hood. Like, I mean, anybody. First of all, Vine, you know what I'm saying? That's my homie. He was the first person that heard me rap, that ever heard me rap. You know what I mean? Before I came home, long story short, he got killed 2 days before I came home. So since he was the first person that heard me rap, I thought like, how could I keep his shit? You know what I mean? His name on. He was the first person that put money into me and all that to do this shit. So it's like, yo, Vine and T 115, we from 115th Street. So that's how that came about. So Vine Entertainment is basically my hood, like, you know what I mean? Everybody that knew him knew he was real right, and he was, you know what I'm saying? He was all the way, you know what I'm saying? Right. So it was like, it was all love, you know what I'm saying? At the same time, it wasn't about fear, it was about just the love and respect, you know what I'm saying, that he gave and that we gave back. So, you know what I mean? It's just a hood thing, but... My team,
so your boy Scorch, you know, that's
115, man. Right. That's my hood, man. We grew up, man. You know what I'm saying?
But you reside in Jersey now, right?
Yeah, I'm in Jersey.
That's to keep your ass out of trouble?
Yeah, that's to keep me out of trouble.
I knew.
Yeah, like, you know what I mean? I came home and I said, yo, I gotta stay out of trouble, man. You know what I'm saying? I gotta move a certain type of way. You know, basically, just staying out these police way because they should kill people.
So that's what I read in your bio then, that you lived out in upstate and stuff, right? Don't think I ain't read and research you, man. We gonna have and give me the best, man.
Of course, I was upstate. I was locked up. I was up north. That's where they had me. They had my DID number. They had me on the census. Yeah, I lived up there. Yeah.
We stood that up there.
With about 24,000 people.
Yeah,
man.
So you did what? How long you did up there?
I did about, 3.5 up there. I did about 1.5 on the island, and something like that.
C-76?
Nah.
C-74?
Three building.
Yeah.
Five Main, House of Pain. Know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Like, niggas come in talking that bullshit. Yo, man. Yo.
I wasn't for the telephone.
You know, be quick, man.
I wasn't for the telephone.
Oh, man.
I know that's a whole nother story to itself, right?
Oh, man.
I
ain't even gonna sit here in front like I had the... Yeah, it ain't nothing like that.
Like you wanted, man.
I got her phone, though. I would just say that. Like, I wasn't, Visa on the phone, but I got her phone.
So your time up there, man, mom and pops, they came visit you, make sure commissary was filled. Who was this?
Pops was locked up. Pops was doing about 5 years.
Man.
You know, he a hustler. He was doing about 5 years, so... Moms was sending stuff. My stepmoms, my real moms.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to Nita. Shout out Rose. You know what I'm saying? They were sending me cards.
They still supportive and like what you're doing and keep yourself maintained.
Yeah,
man.
Those are my biggest supporters.
So you got other siblings?
I got sisters and brothers. I don't even know, bro. I just, matter of fact, shout out to Cheryl and Gregory. Mm-hmm. Shout out to June Gregory. I just met them. They live in Louisiana.
And your birthday?
That's my father's kid. So that's my brother and sister.
Can you remember their birthdays?
Nah, I don't remember their birthdays. I got them on Facebook, though. I just met them, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, that's
so
good. That's good. That's
they,
Facebook,
they about 40-something years old, like, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean? My pops, he's my pop. That's my sister and brother. Like, they was taken from us about 30 years ago. The baby mom just walked out with my pops. He was sick.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? That's what made him go to that bag, he said.
Shit,
too.
Man.
So
what's it? Give me a little. I also like to know what's. Give me the greatest impression about your moms and your pops, or who was there that gave you the best impression to make you like, alright, I'm gonna respect this. Like, chill, me chill out. Cause for me, it's my grandmother, man. I keep out of trouble for her, man. I want her to live calm. I'm like a baby, a number one precious. So like, you know, just give me a fond memory, like.
I'm gonna say it's both of them, cause they both still here. God willing, you know what I'm saying? Blessings, man. Like, you know what I'm saying?
What do you take? Like, with that DNA structure, what you rip out, what you give your mom's endorsed to you, man? And what your dad endorsed to you, man? You know, like.
My mom's endorsing me to speak my mind, keep it all the way 100 at all times. Like, that's what my mom's endorsing me. You know, my father just gave me that hustle.
When the hustle is due, get in. Attain your goals.
Like, he used to send me outside, seven years old, go get Mars balls and shit.
Now they can't do that shit.
Tell me, yo, go outside. Go outside. Go to the streets. Like, my pops, he showed me things and he sent me outside and I maneuver, so he showed me that hustle side.
Let's hold it right there. Right now we're gonna go into a break, man. This is Soap.TV series. I got PNova. We up in one of the studios right now, man. So check out the
series. Starch, Ace, we in here. Thinking about how far we came. People don't know, we came a long way, man. I mean a real long way, man. But I gotta go back in time, Pops. I got some unanswered questions I need answered. What you think about that?
I think you gotta do what you gotta do.
Copy.
Street smart, so I caught a come up. Took a bet to Harlem, make them 50s in the minus. Had a couple niggas running while I run and get them back. Can't forget to send a fam cash. Baby mama got a lawyer, she was on my back. Uncle Mike forgot my name, blame it on a crack. Park Ave got raided, lost a few racks. Met Raven, gave a dick, vouch right back. She said I got a slick mouth, I should write raps. Took it in consideration that I got rap. The lawyer said they offer five, so I took that. I took that. All the way to cell 48. Started rapping.
On my block, constantly with shit is always going down on my block. But the cops harassed, always shaking niggas down on my block. You gotta be careful what you wish for on my block. This is my block.
Now all I'm sensing is hate. Now the flow sick, something like Lil' Peem. Always had a slick mouth, never had a whole dream. I was 17, me and Vine in that new thing. If you talk it down, church, you speaking on the wrong name. When I was in the bean, you was out here drinking lane. I'm really from the bottom, we could never be the same. Cause mean I never be a lame, yeah, a couple niggas change. But I choose to stay the same, guess I got a game go. Yeah, I peep shit. Talking and you never even see shit. Better get this, you get looking at a misfit. Who tell it almost missed it? Harlem was 12, we're Fritz Lim. Let's go. All I'm saying that my cloth different. We get fly and scorch it. The trilogy will be out in a minute. Salute to me, I finished supervision. You know you won't, now I'm out here on a mission. I ain't trying to take God off the subject. But Rita Ora, yeah, she could get it. I came home 2 days after they killed my homie. I seen the setup that they sent me. These niggas is phony. I seen strangers show me more love than people that know me. I seen day one niggas act funny with money. I seen it all.
I'm Dirty Promesa. Welcome back to the second season of Soul Dot TV series, shooting up in Ultimate Studios, man. Any information from Ultimate Studios, we're at 381 Canal Place in Bronx, New York, 10451. We got another guest with us, it's Scorch, but right now we got Pnova on the side of me right here. Vine Entertainment, everybody's family, that's what it is, a community thing in your hood. You network, we network together. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for everybody who support the Soul Dot TV series and TakeOver Promotions, plus myself, Dirty Promesa. You know what I'm saying? So we got some joints up on the new YouTube page, on the Dirty Promesa page. I got my man Pnova on there, man, getting some great views, just overlapping me, and I like that, man, whatever, you know what I'm saying? And that's what I'm about, networking with others and doing what we do, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Got supportive cast in the building and up in Ordemans right now. Everybody's watching. It feels good to see that I'm going to show my people something positive. And that's what we up here doing right now, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So, like, that's what I was going to bring. Since your man Scorch came on, that's the next question I'm going to lead off with for this segment. You know what I'm saying? Like, who your greatest supporters? I already see Scorch there, you know what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
So, who your greatest supporters, man, you know?
You already know it's the team, I'm saying. Like you said, Vine ENT, 115, I'm saying. Scorch Figures, PNovacane, be taking over, you know, be hitting the streets hard, delivering this heat, shows after show, I'm saying. So the support coming from the hood, you know, home base, forced to stand up.
Yeah, that's a fact.
Right. You know what? You started getting familiar. I remember you on the Underground series, right? Yeah. Like, right. There you go, up in the spot, right?
Yeah.
How you like that joint? That's a great venue right there, right? Yo, I love it. I like it. Yo, big shout out to Hunter Carrots, man, that's on that one. You know what I'm saying? Hunter Yams.
That's where I met him.
That's right, man. Yeah. Yo, I'm all up in there, right? Everybody know I got the cameras rolling on everything. There you go, man. You know what? I just got some shit, man. Like, I got that footage of y'all, man. I'm gonna throw that as part of the joint.
We got a lot of good footage, man.
So you're not new to this, man. You've done interviews before. Like, what's some of the places y'all interviewed at, man? And you know.
Man, Arizona, you know, I was out there doing shows and stuff with Nalo. Shout out to Nalo, by the way. I'm saying.
Nalo, what up?
How's Arizona? Is it hot as fuck out there, man?
Certain times.
You can curse it, man. This is free, man.
It's hot as hell out there. Word. You got to adapt it, I'm saying, to your vibe, man. You got to know. It's illegal not to have Central Air out there. Like, need that on deck.
How's the water?
The water? No. Don't drink the water.
You ain't running to no rabbit snakes or no shit like that. Nah. You know what I'm saying? Nah, I ain't gonna lie. I really wasn't prepared for Scorch to come and sit down on the thing, but that's what it is. Bring him in and let's go. Let's talk, man. Now we can extend this interview for more questions, more knowing who he is, who Pnova is. You know, you see Pnova on the phone still networking. That's that Harlem shit, man. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
So work. At work. That's how you do that.
So other you did other TV. I saw you did interviews on the radio and stuff. Yeah. Which one was that, man?
FLO Empire Radio.
Shout out to Flow Empire. V Henny, what's poppin', man? Slims, what's up, man?
Hi.
Matt Mizzy.
Bernie, what up?
How is it doing that? That's compared to different from the Soul Dot TV show, man. You know, what's what?
Man, I mean, I guess because it's downtown. I don't know. I mean, because it's an office building. I don't know, like, you know, it was an experience, basically.
You know, that's what I do, man. I think the gracious for Dutch Shelton, man, providing this place in this. If you see, man, it's real nice to hear. Right. You call him the booth, you done lay down some stuff. What was hearing during the intermission? That song, what's the name of that song? It was raw, man. That was some real raw right there.
I think that was like a freestyle. Oh, 187. Oh, code 187,
Code 187.
The revolution will be televised, man.
And they can find that on the SoundCloud as well,
right? They can find that on the SoundCloud. Paris Novocaine 5 on SoundCloud, man. Go check that out. Look that up. Check it out, man. Code 187, man. It's a hot track.
It's messages.
How y'all two met, man?
That's day one right
there.
That's
Sandbox. Sandbox in right there.
My building right here, his building right there. Like, we come outside,
Do y'all vibe off each other when y'all write? Do y'all sit together and write sometimes? Like, you know,
that's
like.
That's a fact.
Do y'all do it the old way style? Like, I'm going to catch your words, you catch my word, I'm going to catch yours. And y'all learn each other.
We sit together sometimes.
Yeah.
Like, I send him the beat. Yeah, I email him the beat. And it's like, when we get in the studio, that's when I hear it.
Yeah.
It only sometimes I hear it right then and there, but
yeah.
It's when we get here, that's when I hear his verse, he hear my verse.
It'd be magic.
It's like we ain't gotta change nothing. It all came together.
Twin brothers and shit, man. Yeah. Like, you know.
Know each other so well. We grew up with each other. Bro. Sandbox for real.
Yeah, so you, I know you in Jersey now. Where you at, Scorch, man?
I'm in Harlem.
Harlem.
Yeah.
Right there, 115.
I'm downtown a lot, so I got a couple of spots. You know,
that's
what I'm saying.
That's what I'm saying. I feel you on that.
Shout out to Jersey and all that. Shout out to everybody. Englewood, what up, man? It's your boy Pete. I know I'm here. But Harlem, man, 15th, man, that's where I come from. That's where I rise at, man. Like, you know, I'm in there. Being in Jersey just mean I got access anytime, man. But y'all know y'all see me in the hood, man. Y'all know what it is.
Yeah, so a lot of Harlem dudes came out, man, especially you know what I'm saying, like Cameron and Dipset and many more of those, you know what I'm saying? That prosper, but who influenced you? Give me some of the artists that influenced you besides Biggie and Tupac. Give me some
definitely Cam.
Do you listen to the old school
Mace, like we came up off that Bigga Val, like
shout out to all the rail brights,
Stack Bundles, rest in peace,
rest in peace, like, Stack Bundles, you
already know Pac, Biggie, like Hov, just that whole vibe, man.
M got it, I'm saying. He
man.
We got something with
him. Rest in peace, Chinks. He even inspired me to keep going. Like, he's nice.
Who's some of the old school guys? Like, that's, I know you said, not just say Cameron, but Cameron looks so young in the face. I never see him as an old school hip hop.
Ah, yeah.
Like,
what's Al, Rob,
Who's that right there? Okay, right.
That's
Ace,
man.
That's Ace right there.
You know what it is, man. Audience representative, man. Fit safe, man.
Man, I'm really digging this interview, man. It's really deep. It's loving this,
man. That's
what
we Big L, man. We ain't Big L. Big L, leader of this shit, man. Not for nothing, man. Like, you already said, man. Say my name and I'm in free. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's that straight all the world type shit, man.
So how you feel about performing, man? When you perform, man, you what you feel, man? Cause I transition myself when I perform.
You seen this at the 100 Garage
joint,
right?
I mean, yo, I'm just giving my people the feeling of let them know. Cause like I said,
y'all come to a Vonnie and T15 Constant Grind show. Y'all know what it is. Nothing but energy, man.
You know what I'm saying? Underground Concert Series doing something soon, like on the 16th, I think it is, of this month. You think we all find you up in here? Because I plan on getting all up in here, man. I want to get back
to
the stage.
It's my first time hearing about it, but
I'm
blessed the stage, man. If some high ups could talk to some high ups,
Have you done Black Dawn?
They Black Dawn Queen. Shout out like to Black Dawn. What's her name? What's her name? Deshaya, what up?
Shout out to Deshaya and all that.
Deshaya, what up, man?
You ever got to see She Real performing up like that?
Cool.
She Real. It's a slim girl, man. With
I don't remember that name, though.
No, yeah. She Real. I'm trying to get her on the show as well, man. She's a talented woman.
She Real, get up here, man. You already know.
That's what I know.
You're a dirty progressive. He trying to holler at you. Progressive trying to holler at you,
let's
man.
Let's go, man. That's what I try to do.
Yo, man, get up here, man. Make it happen, man.
Sing
your heart out, bro.
So who else besides Scorch, man, is missing from this you know what I'm saying, this interview right now?
Oh, Fly Mugger. Shout out to Mugger.
Shout out to Fly Mugger.
How's your relationship with him, Scorch?
Oh, man, it was instant chemistry right there. Like, I'm saying, the bro introduced him, so I know he's real right. I'm saying, he ain't going to bring anybody to the table. So, you know, we got to chop it up with him. It's like he been with us forever. I'm saying, it felt right.
You going to be around for the 18th? That's a video shoot, man.
Video shoot?
Yeah, video shoot.
Snap it, man. I'm pulling up.
We got to get this song done, but I mean, it's a video shoot. It's still set a date, man. Time is stone, man. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
stop it. Yeah, we're going to fast forward right now, so you know what I'm saying? Even though we don't have a chance to be together every day, he be doing this thing, working hard, and I be doing it.
Yeah,
just
like,
bring it to the table.
That's what I
want to
ask, man. What your brothers do want to do to support yourself, man? If the music ain't, the music ain't popping and bringing in the cat, what do you?
You always gotta have more than one hustle.
You always gotta hustle, man. Like, I mean, I do constant jobs, man. I'm always on the ground. I'm always on the job, man. Somebody might call me just to talk to them. That's 150 hours. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is what I do.
We gonna hold off on that right now.
We're
gonna go break into a segment, man. I'm Dirty Professor. Like, we got Pnova Scorch. We here at Ornament Studios, man. Yeah. TakeOver Promotions. So that team soon. So this season.
Yeah.
about you drives me crazy.
Crazy.
I just wanna make you my
main lady. I didn't have a dollar to my name, but you still kept it real. When I make it, you already know the deal. Baby, you know. Baby, you know. Baby, you know.
I remember when we first met, we'll call my first check. I ain't have it, but that really didn't matter. She said I just got off work, why you still running the street? Told her if I fall asleep, then how I'm gonna eat, feel me? She started laughing like, boy, you crazy. Okay, I made you laugh, now where we headed? My younger years, that's how I would've been thinking. But tonight is different, I'm feeling something missing. I need a rider on my side while I take this mission. Someone to hold them things down while I handle business. She said I'm with it if you serious. Last man I had that nigga turn gay. That's his loss, I ain't come to play. By the way, boo, yeah, I caught a case. They gave me 5 out of that, I do 3. I hope you still got me. It's been a year now, I'm still down. You won't believe the shame, shorty still around. Every letter that she sends, she's sending with a smile. That's to let me know that she's staying down. And that's attractive to me, I don't call, she's snapping on me. Talking about what's wrong with you, she thinking something happened to me. I'm like, boo, you proved your loyalty. Bro, I ain't got a chase, I know you down with me. On your biggie shit, ready to die for me. She like P, hurry home, she wanna ride on me. I'm like, yeah, can't wait to take it there. Bonnie and T, I'm wishing you was here. I know you sent the blessing down to me, and for that you gon' live through me. She like, P, you still there with me? Let me get back to the subject. I'm grown now, I'm rapping, what the throne now. Can't believe I found a loyal chick.
Believe it.
If you got one better wife, I'll quit. Let her be the mother of your kids. At least you know she holds you down when you ain't even near. And where I'm from, that's hard to find. So I had to write the song. Now you know I'm rapping mine. It's rapping time. I came home with jeans. My ex said she mad. She can't believe this. Them haters mad. Why? I'm chasing millions. I focused on my craft. Now I'm in the building. Some might say I'm on some sucker shit. Only the real ones understand this. She down with nobody around, and I respect it.
Respect that.
Hey.
If any singers, rappers, poets, dancers, painters, or anyone who would like to be interviewed by TakeOver Promotion and be find it interesting, please submit your bio into one of these emails or social networks. Thank you very much. TakeOver Promotions.
What's poppin', man? Y'all already know. Vonnie and T-15, Harlem, what's good? BX, what's up, man? I'm in the building. Like I said, I did that time, I ain't let it do me. I was in that cell, I was writing, man. I came back, Bonnie and T-15 was the label. You already know 15th Street, 5th Avenue. That's the game, man. You already know what it is, man. We working, man. Dirty Promesa, what's up, man? You got me in here, man. All of the studios. We looking good, baby. I'm ready. Let's do it, man. Let's go.
Welcome back to the Soul.TV series, the second season. I'm Dirty Promesa. I got Pnova, Scorch, right to my left of me, man. Vibe Entertainment, doing their thing, telling us how they bossing it up, grinding for the dream. Doing it. We shooting it right now, Ultimate Studios, man. Once again, thanks to Dust Shelves for providing the location and the time and area, man. So, you know, I got exclusive interview with Pnova. We sit down, we networking, we talking, you know, learning about his life, his struggles, his ups, his downs, people he met. So it all goes together with the music too, because that's what influenced him to get good quality music of his influence. That's about part of your life, and you keep it as much real as you can, whatever's not gonna get you convicted.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's it. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it is, man.
That's how you say it, man.
Word up.
That's what rap is about, slick talk, man.
Mm. So who's the one that, I read your bio. That's how I'm started. I read your bio, and who's the one that met you in the group home? But they gave you a real big up, man, in that bio about how you were good in freestyling, you laid it down and stuff like that.
Shout out to Derek, man. Shout out to Derek. Derek was the staff. I came home from Tryon. I went to Tryon when I was about 12, 13 years old. I came home.
Give a little description. What's Tryon, man?
Tryon is a juvenile jail facility for kids. I went there when I was younger. I caught a case. Actually, I'm bugging. I caught a case at 14. I caught a gun charge. Got caught with a gun or whatever. I was already on 5 years probation because we started that bending the Metro card thing and making the shit.
But started money that shit.
We started that. You know what I mean? Right. So, yeah, I was on probation for that. Like, me and the homies.
It was easier then or it was easier?
Yeah, it was like easier then. Like real nigga that started that lived at the train station. Wow. Like he lived on the tracks, like under in the tunnel. You know what I'm saying? Long story short, but he tore it up.
Nah, I hear you,
and
man.
We ran with it, we took it all uptown.
So they upgraded the sophistication technique, right? The technology goes young.
A lot of shit back in the days they upgraded because of us, man. We drink a lot of water. But yeah, man, but you know, he taught us that or whatever. I was on fire probation for that. A couple months later, got caught with a gun, whatever.
And that's where y'all met? Who was that again?
Yeah, I went upstate to the juvenile, came home.
Who's the one that gave you the big up? I forget the name.
Derek. Shout out to Derek. You know what I mean? He was a staff in the group home. So he was like, you know, he was one of the people saying, you know, as far as being from Brooklyn, I'm from Harlem, you know, they had that complex. And I'm talking about this was back in 99, 2001 and all that. So they had that complex, but he gave it up to me though, like, yo.
Yeah, he did. He definitely did, man.
Nice. You know what I'm saying? Keep it going.
So you said you was a good freestyler?
Keep rhyming. Yeah, I was.
So how you rate yourself on the freestyle tip, man? Like me, I think I'm a 5. Freestyling, I ain't got the most confidence. You know, I ain't the most confident freestyle.
Like, I could take a pen and pad and I could give me some heat, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? But freestyling, like.
What comes first? Write first or freestyle first?
It's freestyle first, actually, because you learning the words and learning the rap before you put it down. So really freestyle.
What about you, Scorch? How it goes, man? When you get down, what's your passion and how you doing?
I got a system when I write. I'm saying first I listen to what the beat telling me. Mm-hmm. You know, it tells you. The beat will always tell you something.
Yeah, it talks to you, right?
Yeah, if it ain't telling you nothing, just move it to the side and go to the next beat. That beat ain't for you.
Right.
Stands for somebody else.
So where they can find you, since you know you sitting in the hot seat too, man. Where they can find you, Scorch, like SoundCloud?
I'm the real Scorch, you know what I'm saying? On Instagram, on Facebook, it's Stephen Brown, it's STPHENBROWN, I'm saying? I'm on Twitter, the real Scorch, I'm saying? YouTube, anywhere, I'm saying? I'm on Spotify, Amazon, you can buy my single that I got out, Rock and Roll.
Yeah,
go to Spotify, you can listen to that, I'm saying? Download that, buy that, purchase it. My music, you could just Google me and I pop up everywhere. You see all type of places selling my joint, MP3 version, all that. I'm accessible.
Mm-hmm. All right. How long you been in the game, Scorch? Like,
I've been doing this for like, forever, since I was a little dude, you know?
Yeah.
That was my passion. We used to just sit around in my hood, Foster, you know, the kingdom, you know what I'm saying? If you ever been to Foster, they got the kingdom and all that. And right there's benches. We used to just stand around there and freestyle for hours on a boom box when you press play and record so you could, you know, capture the voice on the speaker.
Okay, me and my boys used to just snap at each other all fucking day.
Snapping and fighting, right?
Every fucking little thing that was possible, you know.
They joke on, man.
You know what I'm saying? But that's what we doing, promoting, man. If y'all know, Scorch, so does an acronym for supporting other talented artists. It's bold playing, right? That's what it's all about, supporting others, man. And that's how I met up with y'all, man. You know what I'm saying? Met up through, I don't know, we said it in our last segment, but I met these guys, man, up at the spot over there on 34th, 32nd. I can never do it because it's like twist.
32nd and Broadway. 32nd and Broadway. You got it right.
And then, they lit it up, man. You know what I'm saying?
Showed love. The vibe was real, man. The conversation was real. So
to show you how much love he was showing that night. He was videotaping everybody else performing to the batteries ran out, I guess.
That's official. He brought his camera through and
just record it and not put it out. He put it out.
Not just record.
Sometimes I got it, with the business now, because this is legit. Business, TakeOver Promotions. I gotta sometimes cover myself. I got a lot of raw footage of people, you know what I'm saying? And I just can't throw things out because, you know, I'm sometimes, you know, people's up trying to get a come up with certain shit, you know what I'm saying? So I always keep it business. Like I talk real and I got paperwork to prove, you know what I'm saying? So I back it up, man. But I always make sure I cover myself. And I make sure, you know what I'm saying, nobody feels disrespected under the film. But I do have tons of film, man. If you're interested in getting that, just hit the email, man. Like, takeoverpromotion4@gmail.com, man. But not to take away none of your segues, this is your time, you're the feature on the show. You know what I'm saying? Tell me a little bit more about you, Scorch, because I started with Pnova.
Right.
And you know what I'm saying? Tell me a little bit more, man. What was your upcomings, man, that most of the things that brought you up, man, to where you stand strong on your two feet, man.
Well, you know what I'm saying? My father, he passed away when I was young, you know what I'm saying? Word, 6 going on 7, so I can remember funeral night. I'm downstairs. He did music, by the way, you know saying? Could pull him up, the charts, the world famous charts. He had a hit song, sold millions, you know what I'm saying? So I was around music since I was a young dude, you know what I'm saying? But when I knew, you know what I'm saying, that it was time for me to do the next stage of my life and move into that adulthood when I was a young dude, I had to take on a lot of responsibilities. I remember him saying, listen, you the man of the house now. I'm sitting on my mother's lap, funeral now, crying, tears, I'm sitting on her lap. Like, wipe them tears off and go sit down on your own seat. Now to this day, I know that was his voice that told me that. He said, you the man of the house, sit down on your own seat. I'm saying, and that's what it was.
Yeah.
I adopted that whole me being the man of the house into my character. I'm out hitting the streets young, you know, doing what I had to do. By any means, my family's going to eat. Got into trouble, you know what I'm saying? Like, hit the ground running. A lot of times I was with my, you know what I'm saying, partner in crime. We was young, and we was taught if you want it, you got to go out and get it.
Day one shit for real, man.
So, you think that music helped it out, that changed your life? What changed it to, like, let me maintain, man? Like, I don't know. Probably still running wild and shit, but I don't know. But to me, y'all look like maintain decent, you know, gentlemen. Right. You know what I'm saying? Striving right now, seeing another outcome, another outlet to out of this, you know, your situation. Right. So it has to do with hip-hop.
The music was a platform to get away from it all, you know? Like, sometimes you have to escape your reality, but you never fully get away from it. So it's a way to channel your emotions. I smut it out.
I smell
a lot of blood smoke.
That'll
ease your mind.
Yeah, but not to get you. I just wanted to be a little. Well, go ahead, finish.
That'll definitely do it. But nah, for real though, like niggas just. Know what I'm saying, you gotta just stay focused on your craft.
It's
a
fact.
Don't let nobody tell you what to do.
Nobody gonna put no more.
See something. Go for it.
So, Scorch, a little bit, you know what I'm saying? We only got 30 seconds left before the segue.
Right.
What does your sound like, man? It's up and down, or it's just with the mode and the tone?
Yeah, it goes with the tone of how I'm feeling with the music, what the music says to me. want to talk to myself, then I go off that like that. But
dumpy, dumpy, more word. Aggressive type shit. We bringing that feel back.
Or like I'm, if you ever seen me perform, I'm aggressive. I'm saying you gonna feel it. I want to feel the audience. I want the audience to feel me. Cause if not, that means that I'm not doing something right.
Yeah. So we're going to break away right now. We got Scorch, Pnova, I'm Dirty Promesa. This is the Soulthot TV series, second season. You know what I'm saying? Shoot out all in the studios, and we're going to break away to a segment. Let's check it out, man.
Let's check it out. Yeah. Okay.
Gonna take it, whether you're plotting or hating, that gives us more motivation.